Welcome to Age Potential TV. I'm Lori Campbell, your host, gerontologist, and advocate of your best life, here to introduce you to an emerging trend called Age Potential. Here's to living out your age potential.
Do you dread growing older, having birthdays, or becoming of age? Thinking the best of life lies in your past? Well, you're not alone. Jeanne Rogers is here to give you a new perspective on growing older. Welcome, Jeanne.
It's my pleasure. I'm so glad you invited me to come. It's exciting.
It is. This is exciting stuff. You have a unique perspective. You know, most people view age as a limitation, and you view age as an advantage. How so? Tell me about that.
I think it's just amazing. I think all through our life, different things happen to us, good things and bad things. But I've never been old before. And so you don't know what to expect. You don't know what's coming. But what amazes me is that because of my age, things come that couldn't have come when I was earlier.
Like what?
A very good example is the reason I'm here today on your show talking about the advantages of being old. If I weren't old, I wouldn't be here. You'd have no use for a 20-year-old coming in to try to talk about what it's like to be 82, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. And so that's one of my advantages is my age. Also for a person my age to have my own business, people don't expect that. They wonder, what's this all about? The fact that I've also not only become a motivational speaker and an entertainer, and they think, what's that all about? It's like, when do you retire? And all I can say is, I don't know. But it hasn't happened yet.
Right, right. Exciting stuff. You know, obviously a healthy self-perception mm-hmm. is important. You would agree with me, right?
Absolutely.
So if we want society to shift their perception of older adults, to begin to think of older adults as contributing, capable, purpose-filled, mm-hmm. don't you think that it first has to start with our own self-perception?
I think a lot of it, yes, to answer your question directly. Mm-hmm. I think people need to accept themselves for who they are. Mm. To say, okay, yes, I do have some talent. I'm not the most talented, but I have some. I can do this. I can't do it as well as other people, but I can do it. Mm-hmm. And I know even in the one-woman shows that I do, I sing. I'm not a singer. I haven't had, you know, a life of vocal lessons and all that sort of thing. But at my age, people are very kind. And if you can carry a tune in a bucket, they're okay with that, you know?
And you're having fun. That's the main thing,
right? It's wonderful. It's wonderful.
Sure.
And when I decided to do all of this, I wanted it to be motivational, inspirational, entertainment, as well as the speeches. And so in the midst of all the fun and the horsing around that goes on in the shows, you're getting some major points across that are good to get across. And you can do it.
Some teaching moments, it
absolutely.
Sounds like. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? You're already hitting on what I'm leading into. You know,
okay.
Most people, you know, mid-age kind of start to become very stagnant. Mm-hmm. But you've kept evolving through your life, and you've mm-hmm. kind of started to share some of that. You were a teacher, a speaker, mm-hmm. Then you became an entertainer, and mm-hmm. now you just recently launched that new business. Wow. Mm-hmm. Can you tell me what all that's about? Tell us about each stage a little bit.
Well, the teaching lasted for like 24 years. Mm-hmm. And so when I began to think about retirement, some woman who was a senior at the time when I wasn't had said, anyone who lives into those golden years, it was her feeling they owed some of that time to pay back. Mm. And I thought, okay, what are you going to do when you retire and who do you owe? And for me, it was God was my answer. So I thought, okay, I've spoken all my life. I've done lesson plans all my life. I ought to be able to put a speech together. So I'll become a speaker, and I'll speak on God's behalf. And I thought, sure you will. Number one, he doesn't need you to do that. And number two, who's going to pay you to do that, and who wants to hear it? And I find people do. It's not that I ever say anything new. It's just that we get busy. We're doing our own things, we forget about some stuff, and then when someone comes in, either as a speaker or an entertainer, and starts bringing all that back into focus again, they leave thinking, oh yeah, it's like, I knew that, but I haven't thought about it for years. Mm. And so they do want you to come.
So in other words, you're making a connection with them.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely.
So does being joy-filled, purpose-filled in late life require any different skills or mindset than when you were younger?
I don't know that it does, but I think because you're retired, you can act on them in a much different way and a more positive way, because once you're retired, you're basically doing the things that you want to do, you choose to do, or you should be. And I think this is one of the greatest things that I took out of your book, Awaken Your Potential. I'm just to the part now where I'm going to start reading about all those wonderful people, including Connie, who was in your show not too long ago. But the two words I'm coming up with, your whole book is could be, what your retirement could be, what your older age could be. And that implies a whole lot of things that maybe you never thought of. You're not doing them.
Dreaming. You get could. Outside the box.
You could, yeah. Yes. And my whole feeling, too, is that aches and pains, these things do come when you get older. But most of them, I find, are fixable. It might be medication. It might be a pill. It might be a little bit of therapy. It might be something else. But they're fixable. Maybe you can't do it as well, but you can still do it. Maybe you can't jog anymore, but you can walk, you know, or whatever it might be. I think it's so important, that whole idea of could be. And your book is just filled with so many credentials of other people besides yourself who say, yes, it could be so much better.
Wonderful,
if
wonderful.
If you choose to make it that way, absolutely.
Yes, yes. Well, it's evident you love life. It appears that you are comfortable with who you are, not only at this stage of life, but it sounds like all throughout life. Not that there, not that I'm implying there hasn't been some time, times that you've experienced other than that, but how does one nurture that acceptance of self so much that you just are open to express self like you do?
I think you need to accept who you are, where you are.
I mean, people want to do that, Jeanne, but how do you do that? What's the first step?
Well, I'm not sure that I actually know the first step. I do know that all the way through life, we're presented with things. Many of them seem to be problems, and I love what you have on page 21 of your book. You have a diagram, and I think it's so worth repeating it, so please let me do so. You say, you know, if you don't have a problem, you don't need to worry. If you do have a problem, can you fix it? And if you say, yes, I can fix it, then you don't need to worry. But you also say, well, if I have a problem and I can't fix it, you still don't need to worry. And people in their older years need to get that. They need to get, I'm so glad that's in your book. I think that is the most wonderful thing, because you're saying, it could be. Again, that's the two words that keep coming back as I read more and more about it, is that what your life could be if you just open up and let go and look at possibilities and do new things, try stuff that maybe you've wanted to do all your life, but you couldn't because you were an employee. Well, you're not anymore when you're retired.
You like
can
that.
Do.
More freedom. Freedom.
That's right.
Yeah.
To do all those things. You know, if you wanted to be a fireman, maybe you can't be that now. You're retired. But had you ever thought of going and offering to volunteer at the fire department? Check it out and see. You ever wanted to be a helper in a hospital? Call them up and see, do you ever accept volunteers and what do you need?
What do we have to lose, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. We have nothing. That's such a big point in retirement. We don't have anything to lose.
Right, right.
We don't have our job. We don't, our marriage, if that's the case, doesn't depend on what I do.
Sure.
It's wonderful stuff.
Oh, such freeing, encouraging, empowering stuff, isn't it?
It is.
Yes, yes. So tell me a little bit about your new career you just launched.
Well, are you present promotions, yes. This is recent within just the last few years, but what I'm doing, I found that what I needed as a speaker or an entertainer was an agent. I needed somebody to go out and let the world know here I am. And I thought, I can't afford to do that. And so I thought, you need to become what you need. So I started Presence Promotions. And what I do now is promote other performers and other speakers. And of course, what turned out is that they're all on my website. People can come and
see. And your website is?
www.presencepromotions.net. Very easy to see it. But there they all are and what they do. And what I never thought of when I did this is that that's also driving people to my website, and people find out, oh, she's a talker. She does stuff other than promote other people. And so that whole what goes around comes around, that's mm-hmm. another example of mm-hmm. how that worked for me. Mm-hmm.
So you get a lot of joy from promoting other people, but it's also helping you be promoted.
Sure it is.
Sure.
But it's so much more fun to talk about other people and how good they are at what they do or whatever it is they're trying to do. And it's like your book, I'm just having the time of my life reading this because I think it's just fabulous. And I'm so grateful you chose to write it.
Thank you.
And your whole life as a gerontologist is just amazing to me. I mean, that little bit of history is in there as well. So
thank you, Jeanne.
It's wonderful.
I hate to do this, but any last words that you want to share?
I have three, and they're from my three one-woman shows. The one about celebrating life, happy birthday is, while you have life, live life. For my show about white hair, wit, and wisdom, the advantages of growing old, it's keep on keeping on. And from my Christmas show, what you get, what you give.
Oh, love it. And words to live by.
Absolutely.
Well, thank
absolutely.
You, Jeanne. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much, Lori.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Jeanne is a fine example of how wonderful, wonderful growing old can be. Won't you, like Jeanne, begin to perceive your age as an advantage?